So there are the start lists of the top 12 duets at the Olympic Games. And Canada, Greece, Austria, Mexico, the USA, France. There are some big names of the synchronized swimming world in the final. Russia, China, Japan, Italy, the Ukraine and Spain. And Andrea, have there been any teams that have surprised you in terms of their form coming into this? Because it is quite close, isn't it, as we look at that score from the technical routine?
Yep, it's really close. Any of the top five could get on that podium. I think the one that I've been most surprised with was Ukraine being ahead of Japan after the technical program yesterday. And you could see from the expression on their faces that they were so ecstatic about that.
Well, lots of support in the crowd for each of these 12 nations. We did start with 24 nations in this competition, and they were there for the prelim and the technical routine, the prelim of the free and then the technical routine. But we have now whittled it down to 12 top teams. We do have a judging panel for execution, for artistic impression, and also difficulty. Now, we see five names on each of these juries. Can you explain how the scoring works for this?
Yep, so the way it works is that they all give their score. The highest and lowest from each panel don't count. It's then averaged out and either times by three or times by four. That probably sounds really complicated, but what you need to bear in mind is that the execution is worth 30% of the overall score, as is the difficulty, but the artistic impression is worth 10% more, and that's why it's times by four. So that gives the overall score for today. That's then added to the technical program from yesterday to give the final score.
And that's why we have you here, to assist us in understanding what the judges are seeing. As we have the first team lined up to open up the program, this is the team from Canada. You see the nerves, just trying to settle them, taking some big gasps of air. And that is Jacqueline Simoneau and Karine Thomas. Jacqueline is 19 years of age, Karine is 27. They both live in Montreal. And Karine has had some Olympic experience, been to one games prior to this. How important is it to have Olympic experience previous to performing on this big stage? Or is World Championships enough to give you an insight of what it's going to be like?
I think for Jacqueline, the fact that she has been to Junior World Championships and World Championships, they're both really big events. She got a silver at the Junior Worlds. You know, they are massive events in their own right. This is just a thrill to be at an Olympic Games. And, you know, I've been following her progress. I love watching her swim. This first performance will be absolutely outstanding. There's Karen leading them on. Jacqueline bringing up the rear. They won't be happy that they were drawn first, but great to see so much support here for them.
And they will come onto the deck. How long are they allowed on the deck, and how much time is included in the performance on deck in the score?
Okay, so they're allowed 30 seconds for the walk-on here, and they try and sort of set the scene of what it is that they're going to do. Then you'll hear a whistle, and then they're allowed 10 seconds, and they must be in the water, otherwise there'll be a one-point penalty.
This is Take My Heart.
So this is their interpretation of heartbreak, an emotion. It's very, very artistic. I love this. Each routine, 3 minutes long. It will take 15 seconds. Judges looking to make sure that they motor down the pool, even in the upside down, that the angles are well synchronized. That was great. Slightly too close together there. Assisted lift, not allowed to touch the bottom of the pool. Rope in the background, that shows they've already nearly done 25 meters. Very important to get lots of variety of movement, really use the body. You can see it underneath the water there, they were arching, they were piking. Yeah. quickly into the highlights. Unlike the technical program, this is a completely free routine on the choreography. No required elements at all. Lovely. Lovely underwater shot of the 8 feet and leg kick that water polo players use. Doesn't that look stunning? And you can see the sculling technique really well there. One arm above the head as they rotate. Sculling techniques. What a wonderful performance there from Canada. They always like to do something different, and they certainly did. Very, very creative from their coach, Chen Wang, on the right.
Well, wonderful performances from Jacqueline Sinot and Corinne Thomas. They came in seventh after the technical routine. This is the free routine. It was just stunning.
This is the assisted lift here. As I said, they're not allowed to touch the bottom of the pool, the swimmer underneath. Takes a huge amount of strength from the swimmer underneath, but also the swimmer at the top holding onto that core strength. Men Cheng has said that they are extremely powerful. Here was the sculling technique. Wonderful shots, very slightly out on the synchronization. Arms going above the head for the spin down. Doesn't that look wonderful?
Well, everyone at home is getting certainly a better view than the judges. They do not get to see that underwater portion that you see at home. But just showing just how much work goes on underneath the water to make it look so elegant and so dynamic.
Yes, they almost need to be like swans, don't they? We're looking very calm and serene at the surface, but their legs are really, really going underneath the water. So much hard work goes into this support. One of the toughest Olympic sports, and that is widely recognized.
The score is here are the scores from Team Canada: 27.0 for execution, artistic impression 36.4, and the difficulty 27.2. It gives them a score of 90.60. So again, a reminder that the technical routine and the free routine from today's session will be added together to give them a total combined score, which their total combined score is 179.8916. So the first of the teams will start to be able to compare those as we work our way through the remainder of the competition with 11 more teams. This is the team from Greece in stunning costumes. Papazoglou and Plantanotti. Evangelina and Evangelina, although the coach has named one slightly different, so that
Evelina, just so that she can shout at them correctly and they know who she's talking to.
Sounds like a good plan. You can see their technical routine score there, 85.3550 in the technical round. Spies is the theme.
Moved out such a long way for this assisted lift and the head right out of the water. Fantastic start. Routines don't have to have a theme, but if they do, it certainly helps with ideas for choreography. Just need to watch the synchronization here. Island. In case you're wondering, yes, they can hear the music underneath the water. But they'll be counting every single beat of this music to get the synchronization perfect. Above the water and through the water. Again, careful of the synchronization on those rotations. Look at the body working hard underneath, hiking, getting those quick rotations in. Striking performance there. Duet from Greece. They have to train 8 to 10 hours a day. Coaches look very happy, and that's what you need to do to be the one of the best in the world at this sport.
A fantastic opening lift where the face and the head clearly come up above the surface of the water.
Yeah, and look at that flexibility way past the split.
And you also have talked previously about a change of pace of the routine along with the music. There was a definite change of pace and speed in that routine.
There was. You can see here a few little synchronization errors coming into it as well. But yeah, you're right. I personally do like to see a change of pace. It is harder to get the graceful movements together. You know, sometimes these routines are so strong and powerful all the way through. And that's fantastic. It's their choice. But for me, maybe a subjective thought from me is I like to see the contrast too.
Well, they came into this free routine ranked number 10 out of 12 after the technical routine. We're about to see the scores for Greece. Papazoglou and Platanotti.
Costume design is all part of this as well.
The scores for execution, 25.600.
So 25.600 for execution. The artistic impression is at 34.8. The difficulty is at 26.1. It does place them below Canada, and total points of 86.50 for today's performance. And it's added with the technical routine, so the total combined score is 171.8550. So at the moment, placing them in the second position. Is that about where you thought it would be?
Yeah, absolutely it is. Interesting to see, though, that both duets so far have scored 0.4 more for their routines than they did in the preliminaries. The preliminary free program doesn't move forward, it isn't brought forward to this, but it is the same routine, and they're both scoring higher so far.
One of the things that you will definitely see is the ability to have incredible core strength on these athletes. And you will also sometimes feel like you're seeing double, particularly with this Austrian team. In fact, we have a couple of twins and two of triplets as well. This is the team from Austria, both surname Alexandri. There is Irini and Anna.
Happy guessed it, this is their interpretation of Swan Lake. Watch during this performance how they use the water to create effect. The youngest and middle of triplets, older sister not here. Beautiful. Wonderful. I love the grace that they're showing in some of these arm movements. That's not easy to do, to make sure you're exactly the same level. It does help if you're compatible, and they certainly are. Good height above the knees, but out of the synchronization on the spin. But they'll be keen to analyze this video and learn from it. They're always wanting to improve, they say. Into this.
We did see a small error in the prelim technical free routine. Be interested to see whether or not they can overcome that this time.
Yeah, it was right at the very end. She was very, very upset about it. Good news is they still qualified for finals. Wow, look at this. And they didn't make the mistake.
Well done.
In the prelim, she missed out one of the splits. She knew she'd made that mistake straight away, but not today. Wonderful.
Born in Greece, they relocated to Austria in 2012 to take advantage of better conditions, better facilities. Just incredible. They are so long-limbed, arms and legs. They're 170 and 171 centimetres tall.
This is a wonderful sport for your overall fitness. I mean, the athletes are absolutely stunning, aren't they?
Many of the stories are they've either done gymnastics or swimming or both, and then not having time for both of them, they take up synchronized swimming, which is wonderful to see them now at the Olympic Games. And they're only 18, so Andrea, a very big future. And as you said, they are triplets, so the third sister does also compete in synchronized swimming. So, Anna Maria and Irene Marina.
Yeah, they'll be getting their scores, then going to what we call the kiss and cry area to see their coaches. Choreography was done by Anastasia Yermakova, done a fantastic job with that routine. She's a past Olympic champion herself, so she knows what it feels like.
They came in ranked 11. See the scores for the free routine. So for execution, it's 25.80. For artistic impression, 34.1333. And difficulty, 25.60. It gives them a combined score of 170.5970. So currently places them in the ranking of third, with Greece and Canada ahead of them. A great learning experience for these 18-year-old girls at their first Olympic Games. They've been to a World Championships before, so we expect to see them in Tokyo 2020.
They came here really hoping to be in finals, so they've achieved their goals. It's not like the top six that have come here to get on the podium.
How much say do they have in selecting their routine, the artistic side of things, the music?
Yeah, they have a lot to say, and you know, it's really good fun doing training for synchronized swimming because you get to try lots of different things in the water, and absolutely they would have helped to choose the music.
Here are the duet from Mexico. Isidadro and Achach. Both 25 years of age, both live in Mexico City.
Wow. Terrific height. Already covered 15 meters. Now right in front of the judges, as you can see. Great start, real impact here. Very challenging first lap of the pool. There. You can see how she's lifting the other one out of the water using her feet. Lovely. They'll have their eyes open underneath the water. They'll have very, very good spatial awareness. They'll know exactly where their duet partner is. Have to swim very close together with that shoulder flexibility.
What a finish, what a performance. They came in ranked 12th, the last of the teams to qualify.
Good for them though, the only South American duet to qualify. Brazil just missing out in 13th spot, which is a shame for the home nation.
However, opportunity for Mexico. The lifts were very good and getting to see that underwater working as a pair and certainly a relationship of trust when you see it under the water like that.
I love the fact that they're doing highlights and the legs out and then the hands stay out as well. That's really difficult to do.
They're both 25 years of age. Karim Achach and Yuria Disadadro.
The hero is Gemma Mengwell, who we're going to be seeing swimming later. The 39-year-old from Spain, hero to many of the competitors here today.
So they come into the area where they will receive their score, a nervous wait. It was a very impressive routine. Let's see if they move up ahead of any of the teams. 25.50 for execution. The artistic impression was 34.6667 and the difficulty 25.90. The routine was 86.0667 and combined that gives them 170.9935 and it moves them into third place. So they have gone ahead of the team from Austria. So they'll be pleased with that.
Was complete contrast, wasn't it? You know, we have a beautiful Swan Lake and then we had that powerful performance.
Dynamic.
Yeah, quite hard to judge the difference, but
yes.
the judges are all trained for this. They've analysed themselves to make sure they're completely fair.
So we come in now to see the USA. They were eighth into this free routine. It was Anita Alvarez and Maria Koroleva. Anita is only 19 and Maria is 26. Dynamic start as well.
Together and four laps of the pool. And already right down the pool, starting on their second lap. Incredible. So precise with the movements. Lovely, just slightly fell off the spin there. To watch the execution. And now for a little bit of contrast. Very quickly into the highlights. That's how it should be, a surprise for the judges. Their coach, Lolly Montico, on a fabulous, fabulous job with this pair. She said they really focus on the difficulty of the routine, so it's comparable to the very top in the world. Lovely support skull there. Fantastic to see both under and over shots at the same time. Synchronisation. Down. Goodness me.
Wow.
Some routines just make me feel completely breathless, even though I'm sitting up here and I was breathing all the way through that. That was incredible.
It finished fast and furious. The job was the comment from coach to coach. You see some of these highlights and the lift in particular, where she flipped all the way around, showing flexibility, but also the strength of the lift.
Tremendous flexibility. But even there, both of them coming out really high. That shows how powerful and strong they are. Look at the judges really, really focusing. You can see there that one of them just fell off that spin slightly. But hey, I'm being ultra critical. Look at the flexibility. Love it.
And also we have the super slow-mo that we can watch as TV commentators and at home, but the judges do not use any kind of TV or video review of this.
No, they don't. And you can see the synchronization, it just shows up a little bit more, but the judges would have spotted that as well.
Well, Anita Alvarez's mum is a past synchronized swimmer, so I guess it was always a foregone conclusion that she would be involved in synchronized swimming. And Maria Korolyva is Russian-born, moved to the US as a nine-year-old.
The scores.
Another second Olympic Games.
Execution. 26.300
for execution. The artistic impression, 34.5333. The difficulty, 26.70. It gave them a final score for the free routine of 87.5333. So combined with their technical routine, it gives them 173.9945, and it moves them into second place with Canada just sitting ahead of them.
They'll be pleased with that. That's nearly one whole point more than they scored in the preliminary round. So good job.
Team USA also in the stands. Competitors now from France, we have Lara Ange, and we have Margot Chrétien. Chrétien said that she wanted to swim, but she couldn't find a place at the swimming club, so she tried synchro instead. And here she is now at the Olympic Games, representing in synchronized swimming. African feel to this.
And recovered from the dive very, very quickly into these highlights. They don't have to dive in, they can jump. It's their choice. Most dive to get in front of the judges very quickly. Very artistic routine. Traveling in support, Skull. Look at the speed they're moving, that really shows it up. Then arms above their head for a continuous spin down. That's so important. Help with the artistic score. Wow. The 1 minute they're high out of the water, then they're below the shoulders, then they're high again. Excellent. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. 8-hour training day. About half of that will be spent in the water, the other half on land, in the gym, drilling the routines, walking them through, getting the sharpness, watching the videos, analyzing every part of this performance. Difficulty in here. Two legs out of the water, nice and high above the knees. Julie Faber, their coach.
So well done to the team from France. Some of these competitors will also be doing the team event, is that right?
Yes.
So
yes,
they have to also be focused on a different routine, as we see the lift of the French team.
Yeah, so the teams follow on after the duets in a few days' time. There's only 8 teams in it from across the world. There is a qualification process to get a team here. So if you have a team here, you can automatically enter into the duet. But if you haven't got a team here, then you have to qualify for duet as well. But teams are just, if you think this is amazing, you should see the teams. 8 swimmers in the water at any one time. It's so acrobatic. It's thrilling to watch.
Well, the good news is I will see the teams alongside you, Andrea Holland, so thank you for the invitation. As we see the final elements of this French team, this is the free routine, so there's no required elements. So they get to do as they please.
Absolutely.
And France have done it nicely today. Laura Ange and Margot Chrétien, 24 and 23 respectively.
The scores for execution, 26.50.
Well, it's a good score. It's moved them up into second place. Execution, 26.5. Artistic impression, 35.0667, difficulty 26.40. So this routine is 87.9667, and it's given them a total score when you add the technical routine of 174.2491, and they love it. They love the fact that they have moved straight up to second place. They came in ninth into this routine after the technical. So just ahead of them now is Canada. So the standings as we go to the seventh pair duet, and it is Russia that we'll see in a moment, but the standings so far are Canada, France, USA, Greece, Mexico and Austria.
Emotional scenes here, so emotional. But now we're on to the second group of 6 in the draw.
So the Russian Federation, we have Natalia Ishchenko, she's 30 years of age. This is her third Olympic Games. She's won gold medals before. And we have Svetlana Romashina. She's 26 years of age and also gold medalist previously. Multiple gold medalists, both of them.
Their interpretation of mermaids. It will be exquisite, it will be intricate, it will be amazing. Watch very, very carefully. They are awesome. Technical event, but they still can't afford to make a mistake. The others are right behind them. Beautiful. So incredibly talented, so high in the water, using all of their body. Wonderful interpretation. Beautiful choreography, so creative. In this 3-minute routine. Remember, they're being judged on execution, synchronization, and the difficulty. And they're ticking all the boxes.
We've seen from other sports gold medal favourites come in and crumble under the pressure of the Olympic Games, but not this pair. Natalia Ishchenko, as we look at this lift, this was one of two opening lifts. It was like watching mystical mermaids frolic in the water. It was just beautiful. And along with Natalia is Svetlana Romashina. The control.
Just incredible, isn't it? And even in slow motion, still perfectly synchronized. I really didn't see any synchronization errors in that performance. And although you can't see on the screen whether they get 10s, but we'll certainly tell you if they do, because those scores are sort of kept behind the scenes. You just see a score for execution, artistic, and difficulty. But we'll keep an eye on it and we'll let you know.
They're taking their time considering the scores for the Russian pair. Russia, the defending champions in this.
Anxious moment for them, but they look happy. They know they've done a good job.
Their technical routine was 96.4577. What is the free routine going to be?
They scored 98.06 in the preliminary round, so...
Suspense. Oh, here they are, the scores for the Russian pair. What a score. Total was 98.5333. Broken down as 29.50 for execution, artistic impression 39.3333, difficulty 29.70, and it gives them a total of 194.9910 and shoots them up to first.
And that equates to 9.8, 9.9, but they didn't get the elusive 10, but it was at... Oh, yeah, hang on a minute, they did get 110 for difficulty, and 110 for execution.
But as you explained,
that
they do
count.
Cancel out the
yes.
top score and the bottom score, or the lowest score. So
they do.
Judges did give them 10, but those scores were cancelled out. So the highest score was a 9.9, and there was some consistent 9.9s in there. So what a performance. And now, I'm not sure how you would feel about following that routine, but Everybody's been talking about China, their improvement, and the fact that they are trying to challenge for the gold medal. Here are the duets for China, Huang and Sun, both 26 years of age.
Considered the gold, but they also know that they've got a number of duets behind them, very, very close as well. Excellent. Such precision. Very fast movements, and suddenly a hold. That takes a lot of core strength. Off the angles, very, very difficult to do. You can see the choreography right down to how intricate the hands are.
Big smiles on the faces of the duet for the People's Republic of China. Here is the lift. What extraordinary height. The strength under the water. As they traveled up and down the pool with precision. Now, I didn't feel like there was anything glaring in terms of marking down. I know we'll hear from the experts or see what the experts on the judging jury have to say, but how did you feel about it, Andrea?
I felt it was a very difficult routine, and you're right, there wasn't really much to be marked down on. Personally, I prefer the duet from Russia. I think it's got more personality behind it. The whole theme of the mermaids, I thought, really shone through, and they were so graceful at times as well. But let's see what the judges think. That's far more important than what I think.
Wenyan Sun and Xuechen Huang from China, both 26 years of age. Probably relieved that it's over. But now intrigued to see what scores. You become fantastically close, don't you, with your duet partner. Now here are the scores. It's a total of 97.0. Execution 29.1. Artistic impression 38.80. Difficulty 29.1. And that, along with the technical routine, brings them to an overall score of 192.3688. So they are in second place behind Russia.
And now they just have to wait to see if they've done enough.
So 0.6 down on the Russian performance from a difficulty point of view. 0.4 down on execution. And 4.7 down. Sorry, 0.47 down on the artistic impression.
Yep.
Here are the Japanese duet. Yukiko Inu and Risako Mitsui.
This is one of my favorite duets. Music is Toward the Sun, which is an original composition. This is The Storm, then it will be Fine Later, and then they'll move towards the sun. This is a stunning routine. They were very disappointed after technical to be in fourth place, so they need to give it everything. Of that time. Very, very quick into the highlights. And the weather has turned fine. Quite exquisite. Look at the synchronization there with the bodies. Really using the water here. Very artistic. Now the storm's brewing again. Fabulous height. Goodness me.
Well, the judges have got a job on their hands, haven't they? A lovely performance by the Japanese.
Very explosive in parts, but very intricate as well.
Delicate.
I love the contrast that they get in that performance. Here's the lift, head right out of the water.
And a spin.
And spinning down. And here, waist out of the water. The first boost.
This is when the storm was certainly taking its toll. In terms of the music that we hear as well, Andrea, the judges, do they take that into consideration in combination of what they see?
they're supposed to take into consideration the choreography to the music and the synchronization with the music. They shouldn't take into account whether they like the music or not. Having said that, I think, you know, it's human nature. If you like something, if you have something that gets the crowd behind the routine, then, you know, it could affect them. It shouldn't, but it could.
Well, let's see how Yukiko Inui and Risako Mitsui score for the Japanese. As Andrea said, they came in fourth into this free routine after the technical. And they've moved into the bronze medal position. They're in third. Today's free routine, 28.50 for execution, artistic impression, 37.7333, difficulty 28.7, a total score of 94.9333. And combined with the technical routine, that's given them a score of 188.0547. But it is a waiting game now for them because there are three more teams to come.
Yep, one of those is Ukraine, who are ahead of them after the technical program, and they've also got Spain right on their tail as well. So, as you say, it's a waiting game. They couldn't have done any more. They did their very best. Big hugs there from their coach. He's coached them for many years, Masaya Imura.
Well, here are the Italians. Just three duets to go. This is Linda Ceruti at her first Olympic Games, 22 years of age, and Constanza Ferro, also at her first Olympic Games, 22 and 23 years of age. They have had World Championships experience, though. A puppet feel to this.
Yeah, you're going to be singing along to this one.
I think I might be. I might turn my microphone off.
Doesn't need any introduction, but I'm going to anyway. Sweet Dreams, the Eurythmics. I really, really like the first length of this routine. Look at that flexibility in the box split. Incredible. And the speed as well. First length, just drifting slightly too far away from each other as they came out of the hybrid, using the torpedo sculling. But making sure they swim right in front of each panel of judges. Like all the swimmers here, to keep the hair out of the eyes. That will melt in the showers afterwards. If you're watching this and you're inspired, as I'm sure you are, go down to your local swimming pool, give it a go. Men do this sport as well. So no excuses. Love that movement. Very original.
Fantastic use of the body.
great extension in the legs and feet. Well, I don't think they could have swam that any better. Brilliant performance. They've got a team here as well. We're absolutely delighted to qualify for the team. So they'll have all their teammates here supporting them.
Excellent performance by Italy. Dynamic leg movement, a little bit different as well with their leg movement compared to what we've seen from the other pairs.
Yes, I love that first length. It was really unusual movements and they did it so well.
A lot of thought gone into this routine.
There you can see a really good shot of the gelatine. The headdress as well, which is just gripped on. Has to be kept fairly small, not allowed to go over the top. It's a very technical sport, even though we have the glitz and the glamour of the artistic side too.
So Constanza Ferro and Linda Ceruti come up to find out what score they have. They came into this in sixth position after the technical. How did the judges feel about it? It's moved them into fourth, 27.60 for execution. The artistic impression, 37.0667. Difficulty, 27.70. And it gave them a free routine score of 92.3667. So combined with that technical routine, it has given them 182.8079. So in fourth position with two teams to come.
They would have been very, very happy to have qualified after the technicals in sixth place, because that meant they went in the draw in the last six places instead of the first six places. And as a synchro swimmer, that makes a massive difference. You want to be as close to the end as possible.
Hugged by their coaches. So much time is spent with the coaches getting this routine right as the next duet, their number 11 of 12. Ananastova and Voloshyna. Technical routine was 93.1358 and it placed them in third position coming into this free routine.
Third place after the tech. They know they can't afford to make a mistake if they want to stay in that third position. Fantastic, arms above the head, but still keeping the knees well out of the water. That really was good. Both so compatible, long legs, and maximizing on that, keeping the height. Use some explosive power. Travel through the water, get the height. dramatic movements, stunning choreography, incredible synchronization. Packing so much into this 3 minutes. Brilliant end there. I would much, much rather be the commentator rather than the judge on that one.
Well, I know you compete in masters in synchro swimming and synchronized swimming, so maybe you can take some of these elements off into your next routine for the Masters Championships.
Oh no, that routine was far too easy for me.
As we see,
I could get that height without anyone lifting me underneath in my dreams.
Wow, they were just incredible. Poise, grace, strength and agility. Second to last team, the Ukraine. Will they do enough to move into third or perhaps second position?
Just very, very, very slight synchronization errors. But the judges really like them. They performed amazingly in technical.
They were only 0.01 ahead of Japan after the technical routine. And Japan's score for the free routine today was 94.9333.
Well, they'll be hoping and praying that they've done enough. In the preliminary free, the judges thought Japan was slightly better.
See what the judges have said about today's free routine for the Ukraine. They were sitting in third. Can they hold that position?
The scores for execution. The scores for execution.
A look of a little bit of disappointment there for them because it has moved them into fourth position. They are outside of the medals. Today's score 94.0. 28.1 for execution, 37.6 for the artistic impression, and 28.3 for the difficulty. And today's score for this routine was 94.0. So they were 0.9333 less than Japan. So the Japanese have held the bronze at the moment.
At the moment, one more duet to go.
And I love the fact that we have pressure playing on the PA with one more pair to go. And that is Spain. And an evergreen athlete on show here with Gemma Minguel, who's 39 years of age. She's the mother of two children, and she has gone to four Olympic Games. And Ona Carbonell is her pair partner.
They're going to give it everything. Their flamenco routine. Very, very disappointed after the technical. Brilliant start here. This movement is so, so difficult to do. Just don't know how they keep that height with one arm above the head. Amazing shoulder flexibility. Legs working really hard underneath the water, keep shoulders high.
Well,
talked about explosive height before and the power that's needed. That comes from doing so much work in the gym. The other athletes in the Spanish team tease them because they work so, so hard. Fabulous. Giving it everything. It couldn't be any sharper. They look so determined. Gemma, a hero to many on the right-hand side of the screen. Just moved to the left-hand side, closest to us now. Oh, watch the timing. Incredible performance from Spain.
Will it be enough?
Oh, we're just going to have to wait and see. It's so close after the technical program, but they gave it everything. They couldn't have done more.
The initial lift after diving into the water and a spin.
With the arm out as well.
Very clever.
This was, I think, my favorite hybrid, because I know just how difficult it is to do this and stay synchronized.
The flurry of work under the water to look so graceful on top of the water.
They use the angles a lot, and that does help a lot with the difficulty score.
Well, Gemma retired for a time and she became the Spanish national coach from 2012 to 2015 and then decided to make a return to Olympic competition. So when you have played that role of coach, do they have a coach? They must have.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yes. They work really hard with their coach. She gets on very well with the coaches, they both do. And she's an incredibly talented lady. I mean, not only she got children, she does all of this training and she runs two restaurants as well.
Oh, wow. Just in her spare time. Well, as Andrew's been saying, up to 40 hours of training a week, both in and out of the water. Let's see if Spain have done enough to move into a medal position. It will be a fairy tale.
Now you can see why it's a kiss and cry area.
The scores for Spain have come in. The execution, 28.30. The execution, sorry, that was the execution, 28.30. The artistic impression, 37.7333, difficulty 28.1. Today's score for the free routine up there on the scoreboard, 94.1333. So the combined score is 186.6357, and it places them in fifth position, so the same position that they came into the free routine.
They will be disappointed with that. The dream is over. They've worked so hard to get a medal here. But hey, I mean, Gemma at 39 yes. years of age, what an inspiration to so many around the world. I know Nicole Bonnell as well, one of my favorite synchronized swimmers. She is so lovely, so enthusiastic, trained so hard. Just disappointed for them, but they couldn't have done any more. They swam it fantastic.
So it turns out that Russia continues this unbelievable dominance of synchronized swimming. The Russian pair have taken out the duet with the combined total over the technical and the free routine of 194.991. Do you think this will be it for Mingual? She's 39 years of age. She's toyed with retirement before.
Well, I don't know. Yeah, she, as you say, I mean, she's retired before. She's come back, and you know, I don't know, maybe we'll see her at the World Championships next year.
Well, I'm sure
maybe
she'll
start doing a mixed duet in the World Championships.
Continue to have an influence on this sport, we know that. So there are the results. Russia take the gold, China take the silver, and Japan take the bronze medal from the duets here at Synchronized Swimming from the Maria Link Aquatic Center. There are the top 12 with that young pair from Austria, just 18 years of age. Two of triplets in the family in 12th position. What a wonderful display of this sport. Elegance and grace, yet aerobic and anaerobic strength. And if you are liking what you're seeing and your children or even yourself, you want to give it a go, go along to your local swimming club and just ask about the synchronized swimming club or the training there and give it a go.
Yep, doesn't matter what age you are, there's fantastic masters as well. People start from the age of 5 upwards, but you know, there are people in the 80s still competing in synchronized swimming.
Duet is Yukiko Inui and Risako Mitsui.
Fantastic moment for them. They finished 5th 4 years ago in London. They've worked incredibly hard. And here at their second Olympics, taking the bronze medal.
Risako is 22 years of age and Yukiko is 25. So you would think at that young age, seeing as though we've had competitors at 41 and 39, there is some time left for them. Of course, the team's coming up as well. Well done, Japan.
Médaille d'argent, représentant la République populaire de Chine. Silver medalist.
The silver medalist representing People's Republic of China, Wenyan Sun.
Wonderful achievement. Huang Xuechen taking the bronze 4 years ago and now getting the silver with her partner Sun Wenyan.
Both girls 26 years of age. In Changsha in China, and Chinese FINA bureau member presenting their silver medal. So Huang and Sun. And they've been so dominant over such a long time, the Russian Federation. They continue here in Rio. Our gold medalists, Natalia Ishchenko and Svetlana Romashina.
Well, they were world and Olympic champions when they arrived in Rio. They've retained that title, thoroughly deserved. Getting 2 tens for their performance today. Incredible performance.
And I assume that was some of their teammates for the team event that were just poking their heads out from behind the back of the aquatic centre to enjoy the moment as well.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la Fédération de Russie. Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Russian Federation.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Federação da Rússia.